I gotta try it. This is probably unofficial, guys. I dream about you all
the
time.
I'm promising, Ray's pupil returns.
17. I mean, it could be worse. Failure. Oh. How did this happen? Your little fist is in his giant hand and he's squeezing it. It hurts. You must be out of your mind, degenerate drunk. The pressure on your hand becomes unbearable. Say it. I am a degenerate alcoholic. I'm a cop. Your fist cracks in his hand like a ripe apple. Pain shoots up into your brain as he's twisting it more and more. The words to the song have changed. Say, I am a violent drunk. I am a violent drunk. Good. He releases your hand. Now leave before you humiliate your homoerotic organization even further. Okay. I'm gonna take something for pain. She dreams about him all the time. You wanna talk, Kim? Let's get out of here first.
I'd appreciate it if you didn't force us into situations where I may have to shoot random civilians, because that won't get us anywhere.
I'm not even sure the one bullet my chamber holds would even prick that Hulk. How else are we going to get through the gates? There must be some other way. Let's go see the yard again. It faces the other end of the harbor. We're done with Measurehead here. Can't promise that I might attack him again. The lieutenant groans, but doesn't say anything. The volition says, that's right, you should do it again. It's the last thing he'll be expecting. Probably. I don't know if him not expecting it would be enough, though. Can you talk to this guy again?
I guess getting past the man ain't that simple after all. So, what now?
He pauses to think. Yeah, nothing else.
Nice aggression with the native. Don't let the chief fool you next time. You don't need to be up in his face. Leave yourself space to move.
He nods in approval. Physical instrument says, not bad advice, actually. This might do the trick.
Let's talk about our right to work.
I need you to be my champion against Jean-Luc up there. No, he slowly shakes his head. I'm not a fighter. I'm a worker. Well, so much for that.
Looking for something, Hunt? Huh? Coming to tell me to fuck off again?
I know you've been giving me the runaround. Fess up, where's the lady driver? He smirks. I don't know what you're talking about. Then why are you smirking? Listen up. You don't scare me. You cops don't run Revachol West. You don't run Martinez. You don't run anything. So who does? The lady driver? No, Kim says. Lieutenant turns to the lawyerman. He means la puta madre. Encyclopedia says, a legendary, and not in a good way, crime boss from Jamrock controls what is probably the most powerful organized crime outfit in Revachol West. Speed of course says, looks like the lieutenant has a plan. Let him do this. For a moment, the lawyerman is silent. Then he spits on the pavement. Yeah, him. Cross your arms and nod. Kim says, then I presume you're familiar with his peones? Yeah, he says, unsure where this is leading. There is little bitches. He's got 'em all over the unions. Not just the unions. He has peonies everywhere. Some say he even has them in the RCM. He gets closer to him. Dirty peonies would do anything for him. Multi-ethnic drug addicts. Sorry. Jama says the lieutenant adopts a rodentine quality. Be cool, sire. He's getting into this. Right, say nothing. You're not peonies, he says. You wouldn't be investigating a drug thing if you were. No, of course not. We're not peonies, but if we were, and one of Madre's drivers would to be stealing from him, then it's a good peonies job to find out who that is. Jama says he's surprisingly good at this. Not bad at all. Look at him lurching. It's not a hard job. It won't take a long time. It won't make Padre Madre angry, he looks at him, but a stupid racist is standing in the way, protecting this thief. His eyes dart between you and the lieutenant. I'm not scared of you, or the mob. I'm under the protection of the Lorryman and Carter's Guild. You seen that corpse in the ceramic armor there? The lieutenant points to the yard. Did his little guild protect him? Nah, you wouldn't just leave him out there if you... He tries to light a fresh cigarette, but his hands are shaking now. The sentence simply ends. The lieutenant turns and gives you a barely perceptible nod. Esprit de Corps says, I've softened him up as best I could. Now it's on you to finish the job. Make him tell you what he knows and probably fail. Minus one, go screw yourself. Plus two, Kim's buff. Plus one, so you snooping cabin, really. Half light, alright, probably failing. Yeah. The main thing is to not overdo it. Even when you're trying to scare someone, the most important thing is, how does it look on your resume? The jig's up. I've got the goods on you. Oh yeah, he snarls. And what goods are those? You know, your goods. The lawyerman raises an eyebrow. This is some kind of homo thing? No, of course not. Just tell me what you know. Make me runt. He blows a cloud of smoke right in front of your face. Yes, this is because we failed, of course. Kim says, we'll just have to ask someone else about the lady driver. Let's go. Maybe we can just go talk to her. We can try that again with the knick-knack stand. All right, it took more savoir faire in trying to get that cloak. Horseback monument, though. It's right here. We can try again to understand it or something. Scoop politics just... Let's all work together. What's a scab mean? Alright, the plaque is all the way back here, though. Okay, what did this king do? Success. Even by the standards of the old Philippian kings, old sumptuous Felipe was known for his profligacy. In what way? Well, he blew through the whole national treasury, starting the decline of one of the penultimate centuries. Greatest superpowers, the suzerain of Revachol. His own maladministration foreshadowed the fall of the monarchy, doing an anti-centennial revolution, an end to his family line and the monarchy on the Insulindian Isola. How did he manage to blow through the entire national treasury? Stories have it that he had his bedroom converted into a treasure chamber where he stored unfathomable wealth. Krugerrands, bars of gold, ornate weaponry, armor, and various chalices. He called it the Sol Aurum. It was obscene. There were whispers. He slept on a huge pile of gold-dipped feathers like some obese dragon instead of a bed like a normal person. Wait, really? There's no way that's true. But wait! You haven't even heard about his fabled cocaine addiction. The what now? You see, old Felipe wasn't just good at squandering the national treasury on gold and ceremonial weaponry, he was also a prodigious snorter of nose candy. Okay, what is nose candy? Cocaine. So he was addicted to nose candy, a bloated druggie? That's what the revolutionary said 150 years later, right before they emptied out the royal mausoleum and dumped His Majesty's mortal remains in the Insulindian Bay. This is a lot to process. His Majesty's courtiers said it helped him connect with his higher realms. Okay, where is he buried now? Beneath the cold waters of the Insulindian Bay, thrown there by the revolutionaries after they cleaned out the royal mausoleum. What happened to the statue? The original was blown apart by communards, then further damaged during the landing of the coalition's airships during the turn of the century revolution, then when Martinez was leveled. Most historians think the coalition's hasty landing may have ultimately saved the statue. If the communards had more time, they would have reduced it to up to even finer pieces. Who restored the monument? Some years ago, a group of liberal, artistically inclined individuals, designers mostly, thought it would be ironic to restore the statue of the most wasteful ruler of Revachol in the poorest part of the city. The statue was supposed to capture the moment it was blown apart, like an instant frozen in time, a rare butterfly trapped in amber, floating on a sea of crap. That's brilliant. So funny and nihilistic. People in Martinez tend to disagree, as do many prominent art critics and thought leaders with more nuanced social awareness than the young ironists. Conceptualization says, those critics may have it wrong, though. There's more to it than just ironism, but you can't say what precisely. Perhaps this art mystery will be solved at a later time? Felipe III, the squanderer, however, with his bronze face up in the air, doesn't seem concerned about what the hoi polloi think of him in death. Rhetoric says, nor that he ever did in life, either. Okay. Now this old lady. Is she the lady? Lorry driver? Pale driver? The woman still has her eyes fixed on the photograph in her hands. In the background, the radio plays. Snap your fingers in front of her face.
If you want her attention, you may need to be more forceful.
Snap your fingers twice.
Where am I? Who are you?
Like a magician recalling a subject from hypnosis, you've jolted her back to reality. Empathy says the smile on her face has disappeared, replaced by the wary aspect of a cornered beast. I was actually hoping you could tell me that.
Never mind. I remember now. I'm still stuck in the traffic jam. In the 50s.
She adds with contempt. Wait, what's so bad about the 50s?
The men have small jaws, and everything is made out of plastic. Why do you need plastic when you can make the world out of amber?
Where else would you be then?
Back in Mefke, during the time of the revolution, the sidewalks and coffees are filled with young people. I was on my way to see a nearby Deiro picture starring Gabriel Buengerro.
A smile returns to her face.
Until you come along, that is.
The look she gives you is accusatory. Who's Gabriel Buengerro?
This is Gabriel Buengerro.
She shows you the photograph in the lavish amber frame. Take a look. A strikingly handsome man looks straight at you, his head crowned with a wide-brim hat. His hair is dark as an oil slick, and his jaw is the most perfectly chiseled thing you've ever seen.
He was the biggest star of his day. Girls used to faint in the aisles of the cinema whenever he came on the screen, and schoolboys used to memorize all his lines.
She leans back, savoring the world she's conjured up. Rhetoric says, in all likelihood, it's a world that only ever existed in her mind. So I take it you were in mess when you were young?
Someone was.
She nods as though her meaning was perfectly clear. Someone? Are these not your memories?
They are someone's memories, boy. What difference does it make if it's me or not?
She gets gruff suddenly.
They are beautiful. That is all that matters, beautiful and true. And they will win. They are coming for this, you know. All of this.
She looks around. Empathy says she seems to derive some bitter pleasure from this strange thought, as if the past will one day wipe the present away like a tidal wave approaching. Sorry to interrupt your dreaming, ma'am.
I wasn't dreaming. I was there, Lowman. It was early spring, and the mine behind the black sun had just come out. The posters were 20 meters tall. Everything was golden.
Her eyes narrow, and she appears to take your measure.
While you people were tearing each other apart over your petty little revolution, in Metke, it was a golden age.
Encyclopedia says the Republic of Mesque, actually, is a massive confederation on the Isola of Mundi, the world's largest state by territory. It's a petro-state, a constitutional monarchy, and as of recently, an outcast due to its tilt to the far right. Right, I have some other questions for you. Police questions.
Why not, Harifa? It's not like I have anything better to do in this hellhole.
She settles back against the railing of her motor lorry. Behind her, mountains of memorabilia, photos, and knickknacks line the dashboard. Inland Empire says there's something off about this woman. Tell her to show you the soles of her boots. Maybe she was at the hanging? Somehow? Show me the soles of your boots. Now what do you want with an old woman's boots, Zarif? Is that the way she said it? It's for important police business, ma'am. She raises her boots slowly, with contempt, and says, I'm starting to think you should let me get back to Gabriel Benguero. You're no Gabriel. Did I say Gabriel Benguero? She's wearing sturdy worker's boots made of black leather. Buckles run across. The sole is also made of leather. Now the other one, please. Just before Gabriel, it was the coronation of Franco Negro. Now there was a real man. There's no aberration in the pattern that you can see. She puts her foot down. Visual calculus say, moreover, the boots were size 37. Tiny. There are too many discrepancies in all this. Encyclopedia says, another discrepancy, although not boot-related, is the coronation of His Innocence Franco Negro, which happened 500 years ago. Wait, what do you mean it was the coronation of Franco Negro? It was, she shrugs. And then it was no more, and I was no longer holding my father's hand. He was no longer descending the stairs and rail. The crowd had gone silent. Perhaps there was another Zarif who came and woke me up, looking at my boots, asking questions. Or perhaps it was one of the others in this carnival. I don't remember. Composure says, as she says carnival, she gestures to the empty square with the statue and the machines. To Kim, she is not odd soul. These are not the boots that made the prince. He takes a quick note. I could have told you that just from looking at them. Her size is 37. The feet of a little girl. She smiles. They fit well on the pedals. And we got level up, too. What are you hauling? Diamonds. Diamonds, really? Of course not, she says, grinning. But wouldn't be marvelous if I was. Okay, but what are you really hauling? She shrugs. Whatever stupid things they put in the lorry, I imagine. So you don't know what you're hauling in your own lorry? I quit concerning myself with that a long time ago. She smiles a careless smile. Besides, I don't drive the lorry for the cargo, if you know what I mean. What if the cargo is contraband? Then it's contraband, lawman. What? Do you want to take an old woman in? Be my guest. Lock me away like bad hand Hermenegildo. Hermenegildo. Yeah. Encyclopedia says, bad hand Hermenegildo's bad hand strangled 300 people. What can I say? Some people just really like strangling people. I really don't understand this whole Boyadero Gabriel Benguero thing. Of course not. To truly understand the Boyadero, you need to listen to On the Western Plain. Encyclopedia says, a boyadero, boya for short, is a cow herder from upstream Magritte, the great steppes of northern Mesque. Mesque, he is a rugged individualist and explorer. Okay, what's that? It's an odd ballad about a young girl who falls in love with a daring Boyadero. He promises to marry her as soon as he returns from the Western Plain. I'm guessing that didn't happen. Of course not. The Boyadero returns from the Western Plain a changed man. One night, as he and his beloved are out walking along the River Magritte, she pleads with him to give up his writing and settle down. Drama says, in the background, you can hear the orchestra swell as the screen fills with the maiden's imploring eyes. I think I see where this is going. So the Boyadero strangles his beloved and throws her body in the Magritte. Oh my god. Then he rides off because the Western Plain is calling to him. That's not where I thought this was going. I figured he just left. You have to understand, a true Boyadero needs a whole horizon to himself. He can't be tied down by a man or a woman. His beloved was selfish. She didn't know what it meant to love a Boyadero. Before I came, you seemed away. Kim says, she's just a distracted old woman. We should maybe let her get back to her things. Logic says, so he doesn't think she's a lady driver? You hear that, lawman? I don't think your partner likes you spending too much time with me. Wait, why is that, Lieutenant? Nothing. I just don't think she's connected to anything. Drama says, he doesn't want your frail mind caught up in something here. Something unconnected to the case. But connecting this woman... But connected this woman tuning out like that. Should you drive a lorry if you get like that? Oh, don't worry about me. I'm one of the best cannoneers around. Camionneers. I drive routes no one will. What routes? Lomonosov's land. Udaknaya Zemila? The Western Plain. That one's easy. She nods and closes her eyes again, letting her mind submerge. The Transcatla Magistral, U-41A, as Estratus du Mirador, all the good ones, the deep trenches where the bluebirds fly. She opens her eyes again and shudders. I'm something of an expert in blacking out. You should take better care of yourself. She looks you over and scoffs. You're right, lawman. I am the one who should take my health more seriously. Thank you for looking out for me. Endurance says, a correct appraisal. You're quite shabby. Thanks, Endurance. Is that all you woke me up to say? All right, are you the lady driver? You just call me a lady, Zarif? I was told of a woman driver. You're the only woman here. I'm not that either, Zarif. Her smile dissipates. I've gone too far from it all to remember what was between my legs. It doesn't work like that on the long haul. So you're not the driver everyone is terrified of. I'm only terrifying to small children and to those who used to know me. Chama says, yeah, it's not her, believe me. Why are you scary to the people who used to know you? Because they can no longer recognize the person I once was. Then who is the female driver I was told of? How should I know? Do I look like I spend a lot of time with the other camionneurs sniffing around when I have my movies to go to? You said long haul. That's the big ones, the tracks. There's no women and men there. It's all just... She hums along as if to a track on repeat. In the middle of this town is a ghostly motorway. It takes all the people where they want to stay. Conceptualization says, in the background, a quiet song seeps from her cabin into the air. You don't hear any vocals. That's all I need to know, thanks. Oh, Sim. The woman stares at you, her mind elsewhere now, on other matters. You seem like a woman who knows a thing or two about drugs. What I need drugs for, a lawman? What I see, what I feel, the great adversary? No drugs can compare. The adversary? Yes, there is a protagonista, she gestures to the intersection, and an adversario. I am on the side of the adversary. There's no coming back from that hall. Rhetoric says, those epithets are familiar somehow. The great adversary, the great unrest. The woman sways her wrinkled shell back and forth, a strange grin across her face. All right, that's thank you for now. Yes, go. Enough jamboree. I need to get back to Meske. Her voice trails off. Physical instrument? I could try to hit him again. It could help me otherwise. I'm not sure if that's what I'm going to use it for. Oh wait, I've got something. Oh, it's telling me I can try again. Sleeping dock worker. Oh, to wake him up. Maybe he can help. Try asking about the woman driver again, the lady driver.
Make way for the master poet.
He greets you with a nod. I heard that one of the drivers is a woman, but I don't think she's here. Do you know this lady driver? He shifts around, suddenly uncomfortable, then looks away. I don't want to talk about that. I don't mean to try, but I don't mean to pry, but I need your help. She may be involved with the drug business. Man, I was hoping it isn't going to be her. He bites his lip. All I can say is, she isn't around here anymore. She isn't some evil drug trafficker, and I don't know where she is. Who is this person? What's her name? Thank God I don't know. People here call her the Lady Driver. She kept her name a secret from me, too. Now I see why. What does she look like? A youngish woman, gruff, but in a cool way. What color hair? Kim asks. Blue and violet, dyed, he answers reluctantly. It was violet when she got here, blue before she went. Logic says then that she may have dyed it again. Is it the woman on top of the apartment building? What's her name? The Skull? Someone the Skull? Who is she to you? A friend? An acquaintance? I don't know. She was the only person in this damn jam I could talk to. She's someone I don't want to rat out to the law, okay? Well, I asked you who's conducting the drug trade. You said you don't know. Now you're saying you do. I didn't, man. I told you. I was hoping it's not her, that she wouldn't be mixed up in it. Empathy says he still is, hoping. It's just wishful thinking on his part, not trickery. Drama says it's true. Widow was caught a lie, but a kind heart is tricky. Rhetoric says, bah. Emotional rhetoric. He knows something and he didn't share it with you. That's a fact. When did she leave? Damn, I don't wanna... He looks you straight in the eye. Please just let it go. Whatever she did, it can't be that bad. She's not a bad person, I know that much. I don't know if it's the Skull Girl. She's a little too young. We can't just let it go. It's part of a police investigation. That's how it always is with you, isn't it? All part of the investigation. He shakes his head. The girl's troubled. If you hunt her down, she may not survive it. I can't have that on my conscience. It won't come to that. We won't pursue her on this. This is information only. I don't believe you. You said she's troubled. How? She's got this darkness in her. The young person's darkness when you think it's all over and you're looking for a way out. She shared this with you, Kim said. Yes, this is why I don't want to snitch on her. It's not snitching, it's just a few questions. It's snitching, man. I know what it is. I was told everyone's afraid of her. You are not? I heard the rumors. I saw the other drivers looking at me strange when we talked. And she told me, too, that she's had a violent life. But I wasn't afraid of her, more like for her. Did this violent life include drug trafficking? Well, it looks like it did now, but we didn't talk about that. We talked about life, you know. She talked about her mind. Hold on, her mind? The way it worked, the trouble it was giving her. When she left, did she leave her lorry behind? Man, go grill someone up with these questions, okay? There are plenty of drivers here who couldn't stand her, or afraid of her. They'd be more than happy to rat her out. Reaction Speed says he's right. There are other options, the race man for one. Rhetoric says, wait, this guy says they're friends and acquaintances, and he's okay with others ratting her out? Empathy says, push Tommy and it will break his heart and his spirit. Don't expect you to be pals. Alright, I'm just going to ask this one thing, though. So you're right with others ratting her out, but you know what? Get your hands dirty. Fine. I don't want to be a butcher, and I don't want to be a knight either. I just want to be a person who can sleep at night. A little fame wouldn't hurt, too. Alright, fine. I'll drop the matter for now. Find another way. Thank you, friend. He sighs. It's like a big sigh of relief. Wow, this makes me feel like I should pick up smoking again. It would help with my rhymes, too. So the race guy. This guy?
Looking for something, aunt? Huh? Coming to tell me to fuck off again?
Or maybe not this guy. The guy up here? The Measurehead? Or one of these two people?
Right to work! Right to work! Shame on you!
Hola, wandering man. How can I help?
You can't help me now. Maybe this guy will talk to me.
The unpromising race pupil returns.
Okay. We're better now, somehow.
The unpromising race pupil returns.
Volition says, do it again. Advice from Scab Leader, too. Okay. Mama said, knock you out. Nope. And it's happened again. The Titan has your fist locked in his hand, like, and he's twisting it. Another fit of criminal rage. The pressure on your already broken hand becomes unbearable. Who are you, in your own words? The degenerate alcoholic. Good. He releases your small hand. Now go, before you enter cardiac arrest. Please stop doing this, Kim says. You're making us look bad. I had a much better chance this time, though. And this dock worker can help us, if I can wake him up. Oh, he's not even here. Sleeping dock worker. That's to wake him up, but he's not there. Elysium around. He was sitting right here. Was I supposed to talk to him about something else?
Fuck this cone, okay?
I talked to Manana about the armor. So? He raises his eyebrows, projecting aggressive indifference. He said now you're now the king of the entire Jamrock? North Jamrock, he corrects you. Kuno meant everything north of 881. The rooster screwed Kuno's words up. Kuno doesn't do south. Doesn't screw with the Madre. Kuno West says, Kuno sent your fat butt running around like jello. Look, pig, he's suddenly all business. Kuno sent you to rough some people up. Kuno played you. That happened. Now you and Kuno should move on. Whatever, kid. What is this? Trying to be cool? Kuno was just being nice to you. He waves you off. You got screwed bad. Now limp the hell out of here. After this crap, you better have something real interesting to say if you want to stay in Kuno's face. Yeah, Kuno says. Real interesting. Okay. Let's take a look in here again, real quick. Right, we're going up, right? That is how we get up there. I want to try it for that code again. I guess we're calling an episode. We've been playing for quite a long time. Savoir faire. Go for the cloak, jump over the ledge. Failure. Damn it. Nope, no, that's still too high. What were you thinking? You're not a gymnast, you're a boxer. You climb way too high up there. Right, I can't do it now. I'll make the jump next time. Sure, he looks at you worried. Just be careful, okay? Looks like you almost strained a muscle there. Hardest time trying to get this cloak. That theme plays. I'm gonna go to the menu. So I'm really just coming out here and stopping. Alright, we have to figure out what we're gonna do next. Oh, I think we wanted to go to. Let's go over here. I'm not doing this yet. I'm going to try to find another way other than doing this, because I don't have a free slot anyway. I don't want to forget anything. And I don't want to, you know, make Kim into, I don't know, not liking us anymore. it'll take a long while. Don't worry about that. All right, the pawn shop, so we can listen to this door gunner Megamix. Okay, and this is later. Later. I don't know where this guy is. That's later. The lady driver. Yeah, we need to talk to some more people, I guess. Yeah, we need to do other things before we can do that. This guy's across the water lock that opens up tomorrow. Same, tomorrow. Bool. I have to find that somewhere. Buy pants, I don't have enough money. Find this person. This is going to take a while. Getting the body down. That's apparently going to take a while. The tattoo's possible meaning. Ask around. Call Alice back. Okay. So what we're doing next is, well, this is still, this probably we can't do this next. Because it still has a little timer thing on it, right? That means it's not released yet. It said in the morning, but then it said in a day, which I'm thinking 24 hours. So I don't know. Our next step is to go to the pawn shop and see if we can get a tape recorder. I don't have a lot of money at all, really. So, oh right, I turned the music off, didn't I? Forgot to turn it back on. Well, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always, seek adventure.